From Charlotte, North Carolina, weighing 234 pounds, Nature Boy, Ric Flair.
It's Nate, one of the greatest of all time, a 16-time world champion.
Wait a minute, Cole. Only his close personal friends like me and Triple H can call him Nate. You have to call him Nature Boy Ric Flair.
Greenwich, Connecticut, weighing 272 pounds, the World Heavyweight Champion, Triple H!
When you are the World Heavyweight Champion, you're the very best. This man has made a career of proving people wrong, and Triple H said it earlier. He's going after Kevin Nash here tonight. Make no bones about it.
Oh, and what a confrontation that could prove to be. But I don't know. Even if I were Triple H, I might not be too anxious to go after.
Introducing from Houston, Texas, weighing 256 pounds, Booker T.
Well, Booker T came within an eyelash of coming to Backlash as the World Heavyweight Champion, nearly defeating the Gang last Monday night on Raw. What kind of a mood is Booker T in here tonight?
Well, you talked about an eyelash. All you got to do is look at Booker T's eyes. That'll tell you what kind of mood he's in.
From San Antonio, Texas, weighing 225 pounds, the Heartbreak Kid, Shawn Michaels.
Shawn Michaels, quite possibly in the best shape of his career, the Showstopper.
Well, you call him the Showstopper, some people call him the Spotlight Stealer. And right now, he's in the spotlight, that's for sure.
Shawn Michaels.
From Detroit, Michigan, weighing 305 pounds, Kevin Nash!
Gang, Kevin Nash has not been in the ring in a match in a long time. But tonight, Kevin Nash looks focused, looks ready, and he's got his eyes dead set on his former best friend, but now nemesis, Triple H.
Well, you're right about that, Cole. Kevin Nash looks as good as he's ever looked.
Think about the dichotomy of this match, King. On one side, there you see Booker T, but Shawn...
Here they go!
It's gonna be a good one!
Alright guys, welcome back to my walkthrough for 2K's Showcase. This is a 6-man tag team match featuring Shawn Michaels, Booker T and Kevin Nash against Triple H, Ric Flair and Chris Jericho. It took place on Raw. And in this match there's only really two objectives. The first one I've already accomplished. We need to tag in Triple H. And the second one is... as soon as you pin your opponent. Now he takes his sweet time to start counting, and that gives the teammates on the other side more than enough time to walk into the ring and interrupt your pinfall attempt. Plus, as an aggravated bonus in this match, you can't really control your other two partners while they're outside the ring, so you can't send them to go out and beat up the other teammates who are on the outside, and so this match can be quite problematic. What I recommend that you do, you need to win via pinfall. You can attack Kevin Nash's legs, since his legs are incredibly weak. However, even though he's a big dude, his head also has fairly little durability, so it won't take you too long to damage him, as you can see here. The problem, like I said, is to ensure that you pin him and that the referee is able to count to three before either Shawn Michaels or Booker T get inside the ring. One strategy that you can use is clothesline Booker T and Shawn Michaels after you hit a pedigree on Kevin Nash and send them crashing down. However, keep in mind that sometimes Kevin Nash will start getting up before you can go back and pin him. So that's probably the best strategy to do. sometimes the AI is kind of stupid, so they kind of just run against each other and end up preventing each other from moving forward. So there's a few ways to do this. However, this might be one of the most annoying matches in this mode, because this game, when it comes to six-man tag team matches, can be quite annoying. They didn't develop the gameplay for this type of matches all too well, in my opinion. In fact, it was easier to win a six-man tag team match in 2K14, because at least the referee went for the pinfall as soon as you... The referee started counting the pin attempt as soon as you went for the pin, as opposed to in this mode where sometimes it takes a long time before he starts counting, and that just makes your life more complicated. I'm letting Triple H in the ring right now simply because I want to keep building up his momentum. As soon as possible, I want to hit a signature move and a finisher on Kevin Nash. That should be enough to win via pinfall. However, considering both Booker T and Shawn Michaels are probably going to keep interrupting this match, I'm going to keep attempting to pin Kevin Nash as soon as I've delivered enough damage, and hopefully on one of those pin attempts Kevin Nash will lose. I would like to beat him using the pedigree, but that seems to be a little bit hard, because as you know, using a finisher drains a bunch of your stamina. So recovering my stamina, getting back up, throwing both Booker T and Shawn Michaels to the outside of the ring, and still finding the time to pin Kevin Nash is very complicated. So hopefully I can damage Kevin Nash to a point where even a single move will be enough to defeat him. Let's keep damaging him. The bastard countered my finisher attempt, but it's okay because I managed to counter his. It's all good, and now you get back up and I'll take care of you. He's in bad shape. He's got to make the tag. I thought I would have been able to counter that, but oh well. Come on. If you complete all the objectives in this match, you will unlock a lot of things. You will unlock Triple H's attire for this episode of Raw. You will unlock the... I'm sorry, this isn't Raw, this is Backlash, I'm sorry. I don't know why I said that. But you will unlock Triple H's attire for Backlash 2003. You will unlock the Backlash Arena for the year 2003. And you will unlock both Kevin Nash and Ric Flair as playable characters. I'm damaging Shawn Michaels here because I just want him to get out of the ring, and there's a higher chance for him to go to tag himself out if he's taken damage. As you can see, I knocked down Booker T on purpose so that Shawn Michaels doesn't have a single choice but to attempt to tag with Kevin Nash. Let's see if this works. Nope, only a two count. I don't know why they didn't run inside. I'm surprised actually, but oh well. Things could have been going a little bit better. I haven't been able to counter Kevin Nash's attacks. It's not going super well for me. He's so slow in his movements that even countering them, it's not the standard timing that I use for other superstars, so that just makes my life a little bit harder. But you're gonna stay down, dude, no matter what you want. Let's see here. What can I do to bring you down? Doesn't help that he decided to counter everything right now. Even though, to be fair, Kevin Nash would suck at countering. I mean, he's just so slow and not that good of a technical wrestler at all. Yeah, you're not gonna pin me, but whatever. I have a finisher move stored, however, I need to build my stamina back up. Only then will I be able to pin him. Let's try it. Unfortunately, Triple H ran out of stamina, so he's going to stay down. Now he's going to have to drag himself out to go for the pin. Let's see if somehow it works. One. Come on, start counting. So annoying. Did you see that? The referee stood with his arm up for a good 2 seconds before he started counting. In these matches, that can't happen. It simply can't happen because it gives the tag team partners more than enough time to get inside the ring and interrupt the pinfall. This is like a critical gameplay error. The fact that the referee lags, they should have fixed it. But I can't get too upset because I need to focus on this match, otherwise I'll lose, and I don't want that for sure. I mean, I suppose it plays in my favor as well, but it's just annoying that he stays there with his arm up for a good 2 or 3 seconds before he actually starts counting. I don't know why he does that. I'm pretty sure he didn't do that in 2K14, but he does it in 2K15, and it's rather annoying. Oh boy. He's gonna try and tag himself out. Can't let that happen. You're so slow, Kevin Nash, that it's even hard for me to counter your attacks because your movement is just so slow. Oh boy. Stay down, please. Let's try and pin him again. Like, he's already back up. And yeah, there's another problem with this type of match, that sometimes when you try to kick out his teammates, they will actually counter and throw you outside of the ring, which is extremely annoying once again. And maybe I can do something here while they're outside. Let's see. Damn it. Come on, it's really aggravating. Dragging myself back up, as per usual. Nope, sorry, you missed.
No, not again.
You stay down. And you too. I can't pin him though, cause he's back up. I tell you guys, this has to be the most frustrating match for me. Six-man tags. Once again, he runs out of stamina, so I can't move for a pinfall attempt. Oh boy. I really wish they fixed this. I mean, in a way, it's realistic that the characters drag themselves out a little bit, but it's just... they just exaggerate it so much. Let's try again to go for the pinfall. Hopefully Michael's down, maybe he'll block Booker T. Come on, start counting, damn it. If the referee started counting from the start, I would have won this match right away. But there's just that lag that just makes things so annoying. Let's try it again. You stay down. You go down. Come on, let's try and go for the pinfall again. Before he gets inside, come on, start counting. One, two, yes, three. No, that didn't work, damn it. Because he decided to kick out at 2.5. Oh well. Now Triple H falls back to his knees. Let's try again. Tag, one, two, what the hell? And it actually worked. Awesome. This is awesome. As you saw, there was clearly some sort of glitch where Shawn Michaels just kept running forward. And that played in my favor, but a really frustrating match. But if you do use the meta that I use, sooner or later you'll be able to pin Kevin. As always, thank you so much for watching, my friends, and I'll see you all later for the next part. Take care.